Hello everyone, today we are going to read a story named In the Kingdom of Fools, written by A.K. Ramanujam, an Indian poet and scholar of Indian literature, particularly in English and Kannada language. So he was born on 16th March 1929 in Mysore and died on 30th July 1993. He was awarded with Padma Shri and Sahitya Academy Award. So in this story, the author wants to tell that the fools are very dangerous, so dangerous, and only the wise people, those are very wise, very intelligent people, they can only handle these fools. So let's see, read who are the fools in this story and what happens to them. So in the kingdom of fools. So in the kingdom of fools, both the king and the minister were idiots. So there it was a kingdom of fools where the king and minister, they were the idiots. In what sense they were idiots? They ordered the people of his kingdom that they should be awake at night and they should sleep in the daytime. Anyone who disobeyed would be punished with death, and if anybody will violate this rule, then he will be punished with death. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. So everybody, all the people of the kingdom, they obeyed the rule, projected by the king and the minister. So one day a guru and his disciple arrived in this city. So it was daytime, bright daytime, and when they arrived the city, they found, the guru and the disciple found that there was no one, everybody was asleep and not a mouse staring also. So they didn't find also a mouse was moving as an insect or an animal. They are also so learned that they were also not moving here and there, and they wandered around the town till evening. So when it was evening, the whole town woke up and went about its nightly business. So according to the rule, so in the daytime they usually sleep, and in the evening time they will wake up and they will engage in their business or in their work. So the two men, the guru and the disciple, they were very hungry. So they went to the grocery shops, and when they asked that what is the cost of this ghee or something, then it was answered by the shop owner that it is single dudu means here 1 rupee in Kannada language. So it cost a dudu, so they could buy all the food and they wanted for a rupee. So they felt it was very cheap, whatever they will purchase, it was only 1 rupee. So they became very happy. So the same time here, the guru realized that this kingdom was a kingdom of fools. That how come that everything, if you buy 1 kg rice also, it's 1 dudu. If you write 1 dozen banana also, it's dudu, 1 dudu. So he felt something wrong in this kingdom. And he told his disciple not to stay here. So as soon as possible, they should leave this place. But the disciple did not agree with his guru, and he wanted to be there because everything was good and everything was cheap. But the guru said that he will not stay for a moment, and you cannot tell what they will do to you next also. So anything can happen, as it is a kingdom of fools, anything can happen to us also. So the guru convinced the disciple not to stay here. But he didn't listen. The guru finally gave up and said, "Do what you, I am going." And he left. The guru left that place and the disciple stayed there. And he ate bananas, ghee, rice, wheat, and grew fat like a street side scared sacred bull. And he enjoyed, as it was very cheap, he enjoyed ghee, banana, rice, everything. And he changed into a fat man. So one bright night, what happened? Then another next scene, what happened? So a thief broke into a rich merchant's house, and suddenly when he entered the rich merchant's house, suddenly the wall, while he was coming out from the house, the wall of the house fell on him and he died on the spot. So the brother of that thief went to the king and he complained that that you must punish the wrongdoer and the compensate the family for this injustice. Then the king said, justice will be done, do not worry, and at once summon the owner of the house. Then he called the owner of the house. Then the merchant arrived, and the question the king asked him that yes my lord, your wall killed the man's brother, you have murdered a man. So it was the dialogue of the king that you murdered a man, you have to we have to punish you. Then the merchant said that I did not put up the wall, so it is not my fault. You can call the, please call the bricklayer. So the king here ordered the ordered his servants to call the bricklayer. Then the bricklayer came, and he when it was again questioned by the king that why did you build such a weak wall, then he said, what was the answer of the bricklayer? The poor bricklayer pleaded and said that yes, it was built by me and it was not good, but that time while I was building that wall, so my mind was not on that, because that time a dancing girl was going here and there, it was going up and down, and that distracted me to do a good wall, and it afterwards it became a bad wall. So it is not my fault my lord, it is the fault of the dancing girl. So she should be present here. So the dancing girl, now an old man, and came trembling to the court. Then the king questioned to the dancing girl that you distracted that bricklayer, so he built a bad wall. Then the dancing girl again pleaded that yes my lord, I was going up and down that time when he was making that, he was building that wall, but it was not my fault. The reason was that why I was doing up and down, because I had given some gold to the goldsmith who was living there, and he was a lazy man. He made so many excuses, he would give it now and then. And then, so in this way, I used to go to the goldsmith to bring my jewelry. Then again, that king's told his servant to call the goldsmith. Then the goldsmith appeared in the court, and what was the plea of the goldsmith? Then he said that I am a poor goldsmith. It's true that I made this dancer come many times to my door, but I gave her excuses because I could not finish making her jewelry before I finished, because I had to finish the jewelry of a rich merchant. So there was an order from a rich merchant, so I had to complete the rich merchant's jewelry first, not the dancing girls, these girls. Then who is that? Then the king questioned him that who is that rich merchant who kept you from finishing this poor woman, the dancing girl's jewelry? Then the goldsmith named and the merchant, and it was none other than, here is the main story, turning point of in the story, and the merchant was that person who was none other than the original owner of that house whose wall fell on that that thing. So now justice has come full circle. So now the merchant was rudely summoned to back to the court. He arrived and he said that my father had ordered the jewelry and he is dead now and I am innocent. Then he also pleaded what he wanted to tell. He said that I am innocent and the jewelry was ordered by my father and he is dead now. So it's very true, your father is a true murderer. So it was finalized that the father is a true murderer. But as he is dead, you have inherited everything from your father, and everything from that criminal father of yours, his riches as well as his sins. So as you enjoy the property of your father, you have to also get the sins of your father, the mistakes. You have to get the burden of your the mistakes of your father. So and he ordered a new stake to be made ready for the execution. So it was decided finally that the merchant is a real culprit and he should be punished. Then the king ordered the servants to make a stake for the execution, and the rich merchant was somewhat too thin too. So when it was a time to for the execution, when he was not fit to that execution because he was very thin. So the king decided that when suddenly it struck him that all they needed to do was to find a fat man. So it was decided that as he was the merchant was so thin to fit in the stake, so a fat person should come to fit for the stake. So the servants went in search of a fat person. So suddenly their eyes fell on that fat person. Who was the fat person here? The fat person is the disciple who grew fat by eating ghee, banana, all these things. So the servant's eyes fell on him, and he was brought to the court for the execution. So when the disciple came, and when he came to know that he was going to die, then he started remembering his guru. So now that this is the time, he remembered his guru, and he said also, I am innocent, I am a sannyasi. And he cried, and he remembered his guru. So the guru heard his cry, and in a vision, and soon the guru appeared in the court. Then the guru, as he was a very wise man, and he knew how to handle the situation, how to handle the fools in that kingdom. So then he went to the king. The guru went to the king and addressed, "O wisest of kings, who is greater, the guru or the disciple?" Then the king answered that, "Of course the guru." "Then you put me to the stake first, not my disciple." Then the disciple again told, no, it's not my guru. I should die first, not my guru. So you should not take my guru to the stake." So the both the guru and the disciple, here they made a plan, and they started fighting that who will go for the go to the stake for execution. So here the king got puzzled, that they were actually here, they wanted to make the king puzzled, because he was a very full king. So both the guru and the disciple here, they confused the king. Then the king asked the guru that, "What is the reason that you both of you wanted to die?" The guru wants to die first, then the disciple also wants to die first. Then the guru disclosed the secret to the king, that the stake is the stake of God of justice. So this is a sacred stake, and whoever dies on it first, this is very important, this is a stake of the God of justice, and whoever dies on it first will be reborn as the king of this country, and who will die the next, then he will be reborn as the minister of that country. So this is the plan of the guru and the disciple, and how they convince the king that this is a sacred stake, and if I will, the guru will die first, and he will reborn as the king of this country, and if the disciple will dies after the guru, then he will be reborn as the minister of the country. So the king was now thrown into deep thought. Then he understood that if they will die, the guru and the disciple will die, then they will be the king and the minister of his kingdom. As he was very greedy and was a full man, full king, he did not want to lose his kingdom. Then he talked with his minister that what to do. Then the king finally decided that that night that they will die. Means the king will die first, to reborn as the king again of his kingdom, and his minister will die after him, so that he will be reborn as the minister of his kingdom. So that night the king and his minister went secretly to the prison and released the guru, and they went to the, both the king and the minister went to the prison, they released the guru and his disciple, and they were taken to the stake and promptly executed. So in the costume of guru and the disciple, they went to the stake, and the people, those were there, they died there in the stake. So when the last scene, what happened when the bodies were taken down to be thrown to crows and vultures, the people came and saw these are not the dead bodies of the guru and the disciple, these are the these are the dead bodies of the king and the minister of their kingdom. So all night the people they mourn, they hear the people they mourned and discussed the future of the kingdom. Now, because now the king and the minister both are dead, so now who is going to rule over the kingdom? So finally, what happened? The people suddenly thought of the guru and the disciple. They went to the guru and the disciple and requested them to be the king and the minister of their kingdom. But the guru did not agree with the proposal. But the disciple got agree with the proposal. Finally, both the guru and the disciple agreed with the proposal, and they finally agreed to rule the kingdom of the foolish king and the silly minister. But the guru had one condition, that he wanted to change the rule of this kingdom, that they could change all the old laws, means the people will work in the daytime and they will sleep at night, and from then on night would be again be night, means they night is night and they will sleep, people will sleep at night, and the day would again be day, and you could get nothing for a dodo. And he changed that, the guru changed that, you will not get everything in one dodo in or one rupee, and it became like any other place, and that kingdom became like any other place. It became a normal kingdom like other kingdoms. It was not an unusual, or the rules and regulations means it was earlier it was different, the rules were different, but now the rules of the kingdom became same with the other kingdoms. So see children, that how the fools, the king and the minister, how they are fool, and the disciple also became fool by entering into the kingdom of fools. But it was the guru only that who understood everything, who realized that, and he in what way he controlled the situation, and he in what way he convinced the king and the minister so that his disciple got saved from death. So hope children, you all enjoyed this story. Thank you so much.